Okay guys, so since you might have downloaded the Remini app, let's just open up the app. On your own app, for the first time while opening it, it will ask you to sign into the app. So you can just use your Gmail account to sign in. So after signing in, you have a screen like this. So on this screen, you first have to pick on the enhanced feature of this. So if we just click on the enhance, now we have to pick the image we want to smudge. So that image, we have to pick it and increase the quality of the image. So let's just wait for this ad. Now as you can see, we've increased the quality of the image. Now we'll just go ahead and save this image. So after saving, we'll go back to the main screen of this app. Now we'll pick on the paint feature of this. So if we just click on the paint feature, the same image we just increased the quality, we'll be using that to do the paint. So if you just click on the paint, now as you can see, it's entirely different from the real image, because this gives it something like a little bit of textures or rough edges on the image, I don't know, but that's the one we'll be working with. So if we just go ahead and save that. So it has been saved. You can now go back to your home screen. So that's just the step one. Now for the step two, you have to open up your Gallery. So I'm using my AI Gallery right now. So I'll just open up the gallery. Here we have to change the image we just painted in Remini. We have to change that to black and white. So let's just tap on the image. So as you can see, this is the real image. Now this is the one we did paint. So this one, we have to click on this little edit button under this, and we'll use the filter of this app. So let's just tap on the filter. Now we look for black and white. So this black and white right here, let's just click on that. Okay, now we have to save it. So there's a little check mark button on the top of this. So we just go ahead and save this image. Now that's all you need. Now next, we have to open up the Autodesk sketchbook. So this is the tricky part of this. You have to know the order of arrangement for the image, so you won't get like some errors on your image. So let's just save this one. So you have to follow me on this. To the way I arranged it, you have to arrange it exactly the same way. So click on that new image. Now we head over to our gallery. So pick your AI gallery. So you can still download the AI gallery on Play Store. The link will be in the description. So now look for the image. So first thing first, you first have to import the one you did black and white. So that's the one you first import to Autodesk sketchbook. So after that, you see a button on the top of this icon bar here in Autodesk that says import image. So this button right here, can use it to import image. So let's just click on that. So you know there is three image now. So secondly, we have to import the one we did the paint on Remini. So the one next to the black and white. Okay. Now lastly, we have to now import the main image after this. So still click on the import image button. Now import the last image. So this is just the order of arrangement. If you want to do the small jet, so you have to arrange your own layers like this when before starting anything. So now I have to sketch this image, so I'll just close the other one. So I'll be using only the real image to sketch. So I'm reducing the opacity and the other ones are closed. So this is my, I've picked my brush, my paint pad brush. So that's the brush I usually use to sketch. If you haven't seen any of my sketching video, you can check those out on my channel. So I'll just sketch this image. So I'm using a size of 1.5 and I'm using that to sketch the inlines of this. So let's just get this. Okay guys, as you can see, this sketching video part of this work is actually kind of with speed. So that's because the sketching part is not based on beginners. So I actually have other sketching tutorials on my channel that's focused only on beginners. Those will take you from step to step from start to finish of sketching on Autodesk Sketchbook. So you can just head over to my channel and check those out. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, so please click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss any more tutorial from me. So Okay guys, let's go into the main purpose of me creating this image. So I just opened a new layer after I finished on my sketch. So on this layer, I'll pick my pen. So I'm using inking pen. Now I just want to bring out combos I'll be using for this merge image. So I'll bring out the base color and then the highlight color. So let's just look for the base. So we pick the color. Okay, let's just add that color here. Now let's look for the highlight. So as you can see, the highlights are pretty obvious. You can see them anywhere on this image. So we pick that color also. Now we have to create another layer. Now on this layer, we have to pick the base, then paint the image. So that's just what I'll be doing. So guys, after we are done with the painting of the image, as you can see, I brought the black and white image above. So I'll be erasing the background of this. So let's pick our eraser, then erase the background of the black and white without touching the main image. So let's just erase only the background. Okay guys, we are done with the painting and the cleaning of the background. So we are done with the background cleaning. Now let's try adding the colors to the earring and the nose ring actually. So I'm still adding it on the same layer I added the base color. So let's just add those. The necklace. So after adding all these colors, you want to duplicate the layer. So this smudge art, so you are doing smudge, you have to duplicate the layer. So that's the duplicate button there. So you just tap on that. So you have to duplicate this layer up to 3 times for your own. So these layers, if you duplicate them, then you use them and give your image like the look you want. So on this image, so we are using the blend modes. Now the first blend mode should be soft light. The second one should be color. And the third one should be multiply. But on this image, on this video, while I'm making the video, I messed that up. So it was later after the video I went and changed it. So on this video I did soft light, multiply, then color, while it should have been on soft light, color, then multiply. So make sure you don't make that mistake also. So leave yours to be soft light, color, then multiply. Now, and you have to reduce the opacity of the 3 layers so it will give your image like the look you want. So on the finishing of this image, I used the soft light at 10%, the color at 80% and then they multiply at 40%. So that's the blends I use to achieve my own look. Now this, after that, the image, the main image, you have to bring it up. So I want to pick the lip color of this image. So for the lip color, I'll just be adding the same the colors to the three layers I duplicated. So that's where I'll be adding them. So I know you'd be wondering why we are using black and white image for the smudge. So this is just the only reason. If we would have used the colored image and then we then started adding all these colors, it will look kind of messed up. But since if you use the black and white, so if you just add these colors to it, you just like give it any look you want. Or if you are using the main colored image, it will just be as if you are adding colors on top of colors. So that's why we just normally use the black and white image for this mod. So I'm still painting the lips. Mind you, I'm painting them on the same layers I duplicated, one after the other. So it will just like blend together with the image and the colors. Now, this is all the image and the lip. Now we have to pick our small round bristle brush if we want to do the smudge. Now for the size, you can use any size you want depending on the area you want to smudge. But for the flow and the strength, the flow should be about 5 to 6%. And the strength should be 1%. Now I'm duplicating the main image, the black and white image, so in case I do any mistake on this photo, so that will just help you recreate it, so not just starting from the beginning. Now you have to lock the transparency of this image, and for the second image you have to lock the image entirely. So the first one, lock the transparency and use your small round bristle brush. Then if you just use your small round bristle brush, then you smudge on the image. So not smudging outside the image or just smudging scatteredly. So you have to make your smudge to be precise. You have to smudge it smooth. Smudge the image. And the reason why we lock the transparency is just for the smudge, so it won't go outside of the layer. So if you just lock it, it will lock the whole image, then everything we are doing will be on that particular layer. So I'll just continue smudging this image. guys, I'm just taking my time to smudge this image correctly. So you have to put a lot of time to it to make sure you get the exact position of all the blends, so not just scattering them off. Okay guys, we are done with the smudge. Now I'm opening a new layer for the highlight. So just go over, so I'm using my flow airbrush actually. Now I'll go over to the highlighting color and I'll pick the dark color there. So on this first layer of highlight, we'll just be adding the base of the highlight to this image. So the whole place you are going to be highlighting on this image, you do that here, then reduce the opacity. So let's just add those to this image. Just take note of all the highlights. So this is the first one, highlighting the whole image. So now we reduce the opacity. So I'll be reducing it to around 15 or 10. So this is another highlight under layer, but now put this layer on soft glue. Now we'll be using little strokes to add these highlights and lighten up this image. And but this is not gonna be only the highlights we put on soft glue, so we will still add more highlights to this and add most of it to soft glue. So I'll just be highlighting all the areas that looks like there's a too much light on them. So all those areas, that's the ones I'll be highlighting on this layer. As you can see, the smudge art is pretty simple. So the art is just simple, just smudge and add highlights, that's all you need. But sometimes the highlights needs practice and also the smudge. So the key smudge, like smudging the image, that needs lots of practice. Now just follow through with this. Let's just add the highlight together. Just like I said before, please don't forget to like this in this video and also comment on this. So I really appreciate that. So I just reduced the opacity of the highlights. Now I'm opening another one and also subs glue. So this, I'm focusing on the nose. So highlighting the nose. So this third layer, I won't be reducing the opacity that much. So I'm adding highlights to the nose. Actually, I just like using plenty layers for my work. So you can just even use only one layer for all these things I'm doing now. You can just use maybe one layer on normal and the other one on multiply to do all this. But I prefer using a lot of layer, even though it's later I will have to merge them. So just like using lots of them. So all those areas that looks like they has too much light, that's where I'm focusing on this layer. So I'm just adding those lights back to the image. So I just hope you guys are enjoying this video and also learning how to do this, because that's just the whole reason of me doing this, so for you to learn how to do it. And so, because no knowledge is a waste, so you too can just put practice to it and start creating your own smart art. Okay, I'm done with that. So as you can see, the opacity, I didn't reduce much of it. Now another layer, but this I'm using my dotted tool brush. This is just to add some kind of textures to it, just like light textures to the face and the skin. So I'll just add those to where there's highlight, so that's where I'll be putting this. I just reduced that opacity now. Now I can see open another layer. So okay, this is another new layer, but this layer I'll be using it for the lips. That's why I changed the label of the layer to a color. So I'll use this for the lips. So this is just to demarcate the places I did for the skin and the lips. So from here up will be for the lips. So I'll just add lights to the lips, and the layer is also on soft glue. We'll just add those lights to it. This is another layer, and I'll be using my dotted tool brush for this also. So just add lights to the lips. So or just add it to both the top and the bottom lip. And I'll be reducing the opacity of it. That's good. So this is how the image looks so far. Now I want to paint the eye of this. So this layer I created, I'm moving it up above the image, but below the place I painted the eyeballs. So I'll still move the main image to that same spot. So if you can like paint eye on Autodesk Sketchbook, so you will just do that to this image. So that's just pretty much what's remaining here. So you can just paint the eye, put your background, and save this. So I'm using a color on that layer I created and brought up. I'm painting with this color. So this is just the process I use in drawing my eye on Autodesk. So now I'll create another layer, and with that layer I'll make the color black. Then I'll paint the entire eye with the black color also. So after painting the first eye, should go over to the second eye and do the same. Okay, well, before us painting the eye, let's go over and we haven't added textures to the face of this image. So let's just go over to, okay, yeah, before all our highlights, so let's just pick our dark color, like a dark color from the skin, and use our dotted tool brush, and let's just add textures to the image. So use the dotted tool brush and add textures to it. Just use the brush and brush the whole skin. Just add the brush to the skin. Then after adding that, then we have to duplicate the one we did. So let's just click on that. Now we click it on duplicate. Duplicate that layer. Then on that layer, you make one to be soft light. So then the second one, you make that to be screen. So you see a blend mode called screen. So click on that. Now just reduce the opacity of the two blends, reduce it to your liking. So just reduce it. Okay. Now we are done with the whole face of this image. Now I can go ahead and then create the eye. So just follow the remaining process of this video. Oh, by the way, I'm adding some wrinkles to our face just to add some other textures. So I'm using the paint apart brush to add some dots on the face. So it should just give our skin like another look, or to be just like texturing the face. So I'll just add those to the image before I'll be creating the eye. So the eye will be the last part of this. You can see I'm using my soft eraser brush. So the layer I painted the OI black, so that's the layer I'm working with now, just using my soft eraser to blend those layers off, just to blend it. So I'm just using the soft eraser to clean it off, but not cleaning it a lot. So after that, then I can create the eye. So just follow the process of the eye making. Okay guys, so seems like this will be the end of this video. So I'd love to see you again on my next video. And please like and subscribe to this channel and like this video, and then add your comments on the comment section below. So see you on the next video. Bye for now.